This is Sneaker Gears. My name is Levi, and welcome to part two, which I know was a little bit delayed, of the most comfortable running shoes you can buy, and or just the most comfortable shoes you can get with a plate. Now, generally, these are going to be a carbon fiber plate, and a lot of these are meant for race day or for going as fast as you can. But that's not always the case, so I do want to break it down. Part one was the most comfortable shoes without a plate, and a lot of these do have a counterpart. So it was going to be a top five, but honestly, there are so many options. I at least wanted to give you the top 10, and the bottom few, I don't even have with me. Either they're packed away or I just didn't want to get them. But with that all said, let's jump right into it. If this is your first time watching, thank you for joining. Consider subscribing if you enjoy the video, and feel free to comment below with any questions you have. Now, if you are a runner, hopefully this is going to help you. Or if you're just watching this in the beginning of the year and you want to start running, start going to the gym, and you just want something more comfortable for you, generally I'm going to recommend going with a shoe without a carbon fiber plate. When you have a carbon fiber plate, and I'll grab one of my shoes here, one, they're generally going to be more expensive than their non-carbon or non-plated option. This is a racing shoe from Nike. Let me put it up here. This is one of the original elite running shoes where this has a carbon plate, which you can kind of see it here. It creates this stiff platform that hopefully you guys can see that kind of flicks back. So what happens is as you're running, it kind of gives you that push off, which feels incredible. But at the same time, it actually does load up your calf and your Achilles muscles, and it can put some strain on you for just everyday running. Now, if that's the case, they do have plated shoes without carbon fiber or that are a little bit less aggressive, and I'll kind of go over those for you. So you can train with the carbon fiber plate and build those tendons and muscles. So there's a benefit to that as well. And that you have it where you're just using them on race day. Because these shoes, like such as this, is $250. Just going through, this is $275. Like they're getting expensive, and I can't tell you, yes, they're worth it. But if you've been training for a race, if you've paid your registration, you're putting the months in, and then it's race day, I would say, yeah, it's worth spending a little bit extra just to give you a shoe that's either lighter, faster, more comfortable to allow you to do your best. Or if you just want the best shoes out there, hopefully I can break it down for you. So with that all said, I got Nike in my hand. So let's start with number 10. All right, number 10 is Nike, and I don't even have them here just because they really weren't going to be on the list. They weren't in the top five. They weren't in the top eight. And I think I got nine deep, and I'm like, oh yeah, here's Nike. And that's not to say Nike hasn't done an amazing job. Even the Vaporfly, and this is the Vaporfly 1, they had the Vaporfly 2, is still an amazing shoe. Really light, really fast, there's nothing wrong with it. But it's 2022, and pretty much every company has caught up with foams that are as comfortable, as bouncy, as light. The Alphafly, which is kind of the elite $275 racing shoe that broke the 2-hour barrier, that is compared to the shoes we have today. I find a little bit more clunky. It's not as smooth as what we have. And then their training counterpart, if you want to look to a plated shoe, they do have the Tempo. And that I found, unless you're going like as fast as you're able, which is again tempo pace, it just wasn't that comfortable. And even if you did, it wasn't as good as what we have here today. So Nike in general, whether it's your Vaporfly, your Alphafly, or your Tempo Next Percent, which is all plated shoes, are really just not as good. And it's kind of a letdown because the Invincible, the non-plated training shoe, is incredible and on my top five if you want to check that video out. Number nine, and this is another letdown. This is one of the shoes that made this video a little bit late because I didn't get it till later on. And that is your Ultra Stack Super Cushioned Hoka Bondi X. This thing has massive amounts of cushion, carbon fiber plate. You got that kind of whale tail divided or dovetail in the back for your crash landing. It actually is a lot lighter than it looks. And this is one of those, you know, Hoka saw what everyone else was doing with the New Balance RC and the Asics and Brooks. And they said, hey, here, hold my beer. And they brought us this sucker. This thing is actually well fitting for me. If you have a wide foot, I want to double check. I think I just went true to size, which is 12. Keep in mind, Hoka does generally run narrow, but they also run about a half size long, because this is a UK 11 and a half or European 46 and 2/3. Most other companies, that's a 12 and a half. This is a 12, but this fit me really great. The cushion, it's a reason it's number 9. Maybe Nike should have been above this, you know, now that I think about that. But it's one of those, it's lighter than your traditional Bondi. It has a little more flexibility with that carbon fiber plate. It does have a little more flex. You can kind of see the flex groove there, where it does have a nice push off at pace. But when you land, it's not as soft as you think it would be. It doesn't have as nice push off as you would want it to be. It's not as bouncy as you would think. I found more bounciness in just the regular Bondi. And I actually just got the Rincon 3s, and I was enjoying that ride a little bit more. So this is their carbon fiber plated high cushion shoe. I think the Carbon X2 and now X3 come out are just better shoes overall. And if you're one of the non-plated trainer, that Rincon is just an absolute fantastic lightweight training shoe that's still really comfortable. And then you have the Clifton, which obviously is always in the mix for just a max cushion shoe. I love the Mach 4. That wasn't necessarily a max cushion, but it's still super well cushioned. They have the Supersonic Mach coming out as well. But if you were interested in getting the Bondi X, I'm just gonna save you the money, and I guess this doesn't sound good to sponsorships if you're looking, but we have a lot of other shoes that just do what this is trying to do way better. All right, number 9, and this is really a tandem, one that didn't quite make my top 5 for max cushion, even though it is really good, and one that's making, as far as top 8 here, as far as a carbon plated max cushion training shoe, and that's going to be Kraft. We have the Kraft Carbon Elite, that's on this one, sorry about that, where this is their Carbon Elite, and then this one is the Comfort Ultra. So when I look at these two, I actually really do want to change the laces, put the black laces on this one, put the blue on here so it accents it. But that being said, these are kind of trail shoes. You can look at the lug pattern on these. There is a lot of rubber. This is something that should last a long time. I've been able to run in these in the snow, not quite comfortable running in ice just because I'm not comfortable. The shoes might be fine. And they're such a smooth ride. The transition, the fit, these were just an incredible partnership, and they work so well together, where you have without the carbon plate, where again, it's less of a stress to your Achilles and your calves. It's a lot very smooth ride, has a nice rocker shape to it. You can kind of see the upper is very thin, very light. And then you have pretty much the same shoe, but with a carbon plate that really does a great job pushing you off, has a nice snapback. But what I really love about this one, especially for training, maybe not race day, is it's not an aggressive carbon plate. There's not a giant push off. It's just enough where you feel the difference. But this is something I could see myself using more often, especially if I am doing more trails or going somewhere where it's kind of a gravel or, you know, dirt, or it's not necessarily a perfect track. The tread on this is fantastic, where this feels like a durable shoe that's lightweight. Kraft, this was a shock to me. This is my number 8 top most comfortable carbon plated comfort option. But the tandem of these, kudos to Kraft. All right, number 7, and this is another one that very similar to Kraft. I thought the carbon fiber plate was just really well implemented. And something, again, that's kind of right in the middle where it's not on the list is its little brother. And that's the Atreyu Artist. This is almost an exact copy of what we got with the first Adidas Adios Pro. If you like that shoe, if you had it, if you ran it through, or if you wanted to get one, pick this one up for $100. This is the best shoe here, second to maybe the one we have coming up here in number 6. But the carbon plate here, I don't think is too aggressive. The cushion feels really nice, as far as it's just a little bit plush, and you have just a little bit of a bounce. It's not super comfortable as far as a super soft plush. It's not really bouncy where it feels like it's just propelling you like some of the other ones we have here, but it is so lightweight. I really enjoy the fit on this. It's so minimal where it's really just a cloth heel cup. There's not much rigidity here to save weight, but you are locked in. Now, the little brother of this, the base model version 2, came out and I got that during Christmas time. That uses the same foam without a plate. And maybe it's not my top 5 most comfortable shoes, but that is an $85 daily trainer. So between these two, it is $185 to have an amazing daily trainer, have a race day shoe. And if you don't like the carbon plate, maybe use the base model because that one is super light as well. But I could not be more impressed with the Treyu. If you were on a budget, if you just don't want to wear Nike, doesn't fit your feet, if you're not interested in something heavy like a lot of the Adidas line is per se, try something new, go with the Treyu. These guys are American, made in Texas, or the company is based in Texas, and I cannot say enough good things about this shoe. I wish it was higher because I do like it that much, but it's lower just because you have a lot more established companies essentially ahead of it that are going to give us our top pairs of shoes that we're coming at you with. All right, number 6, and the only reason this is not higher, and it wasn't in, I guess, my top 2 or 3 in the last video, part 1, is because we have the Skechers Road Max 5, and this has an H plate design. I'll see if I can put some B-rolls, you guys understand what I'm talking about. So it's not a carbon plate, so it's not necessarily a racing shoe, but this thing is ridiculously light, kind of like that of Treyu. Super bouncy, really soft. This is the most cushioned shoe from Skechers, and this again would have been number 1 or 2, worst number 3, but I would say probably top 2 in non-plated max cushioned shoe you can get. But because of that plate, I think Skechers did a great job. It's not a full carbon plate. It's only in the forefoot. It's only an H plate, so it's not this giant slab where it's stiff, but it's giving just enough flicking or feedback where even though you have this much stack height, it feels fast. And shout out to Skechers, they're using this and then putting more cushion in pretty much their entire lineup for next year. The Razor XS2, the new Skechers, Go Run Rye 10, are all gonna have more cushion with an H plate because this was just so amazing. And then obviously the Max Road 6, I don't know what they're gonna do for that. If it's gonna be a full plate, more cushion, we'll see what they have coming out. But really enjoy this shoe. If you're looking for something incredibly soft, light, and bouncy that is not terribly expensive, I think this one is like $115. I was able to get it on sale for less than $100. It's gonna beat everything on our top 5. So keep that in mind if you have a budget or a value you're trying to stick to. The little cousin to this, if you don't need a plate, is gonna be something like your Razor XS or maybe just your regular Razor 3 or whatever they're calling it nowadays. And now we're into our top 5. And the little brother to this, or the non-carbon plated training version, was the number 1 most comfortable shoe we had in part 1. And that was the Brooks Aurora, and I give you its racing counterpart, the Brooks Hyperion Elite. This thing, oh, at least for me, I think everything except the first number 1 here worked best for my gait, for my style of running. Love this shoe, would want to put it higher, but 1 through 4 here have way more cushion, are a little bit smoother. This has just a beautiful roll off. It doesn't even have a heel here, which is kind of weird, especially if you're looking at something like the Hoka where it actually has an extended heel. But I'm a midfoot striker, so for me, not having that there was absolutely fantastic. It was perfect. It's really lightweight. Fit is one of the best on my feet, and I guess that makes a big difference. If a shoe fits you, it's going to be higher in this list or not. We're going to go through 4, 3, 2, 1, and if 4 fits you better, that might be number 1 for you. But as far as just strictly talking about the cushion and how the carbon fiber plate, obviously this with the carbon plate is a little bit more aggressive. The fast version of this shoe without the plate is just a Hyperion Tempo, but I love the Aurora BL. That was number 1, and thank goodness the new Glycerin Glycerin 20 coming out is now using this version of cushioning, so I can't wait to see what Brooks does for next year and for seeing how the Elite 3 comes out. This is the Elite 2. The 1 was awful, and you know, thank goodness Brooks is learning, taking info from the runners, from the consumer, and really making changes that make a huge difference. Number 5, the Hyperion Elite. All right, number 4 is not the Elite, but it's our Deviate Nitro. This does have an Elite counterpart that is lighter, actually for me, fits me better, and runs really similar to the Brooks Hyperion Elite. Honestly, really, really close. I almost wanted to get a second pair of each shoe, but because I already have the Hyperion Elite, and then I have the Elite version of this, I already have two shoes that are super, super close. If you're looking to save a little bit of money, the Hyperion Elite, I believe, is about $200. You can pick up this one. I believe the Elite version is $160. This one is $140. But the bounce and the cushion on this is using a nitro cushion similar to what we had on something like the Skechers, but it does have a carbon fiber plate full length. So it is a little bit more aggressive, but when you put this on, it is soft, it is bouncy, it's pushing you forward. Now me, like a lot of other reviewers, I did have heel slip. I was not able to get a proper lockdown on this like I wish I could. This is so soft, and the cushion is, and most of the Pumas uses this little plate in the heel here just to give you a little bit of stabilization. I thought these were plenty stable. The rubber used is one of the huge signature things about Puma, where it's just durable, it sticks, it's lasting. I really enjoyed this shoe outside of the fit. Wasn't quite perfect for runs. I ended up wearing this casually a few times. I ended up going for a little bit slower, more recovery days. And in those days, that plate was maybe a little bit too aggressive. And then the thing that ruined it for me was the Elite version just fit me so much better, just ran for my style so much better that I really enjoyed that one a lot more, even though this was softer and bouncier, just to give you an idea. But the cushion on this is a step up above the Brooks Hyperion Elite as far as being soft, being bouncy. But again, how it fits and your style of running, you're gonna enjoy one over the other because they are different. Let me know if you want me to do a comparison or a breakdown of those. All right, now we're into our top three, and I think anyone out there, if you're into running shoes or if you're watching running channels, you know what the top three carbon plated max cushion shoes are. And I'm going to break down why each one is 3, 2, 1. Depending on what your needs are, you're going to have a different order of these depending how they fit you, depending how much cushion you like, and depending what your needs are. With that all said, number three, the Monster 15 millimeters of stack, which again, in 2022, we're gonna have a lot of other players, including New Balance, and I think a couple others who are also gonna be treading that 50 mil plus heel stack of midsole cushioning. But this thing, the Primax, this is just a beast of a shoe in a good way. I tried the Pro 2 and hated it so much, I almost didn't want to get this. I'm like, how is it going to be better? This is just more cushions, the same shoe. For me, on the Pro 2, this giant gap that we have here, this cutout, just made it very unstable, and it made you land on your heel and force you to go through. So if you're a midfoot striker, or at least for me on the Pro 2, it was just a horrible shoe. This has enough width just here that if you're a midfoot striker anywhere here, it still flows really nicely. If you land on your heel, obviously you have tons of cushion. That Lightstrike Pro cushion, I think for me, does better with more of it because this was just so well cushioned. I actually wore these at a wedding event. I actually do some photography. You guys can check out Tech Gears with Levi. So I did a wedding in these, just walking around all day, and you could still do it because, as you can see, it's still fairly flat. It's not as high kind of arced as it is, but you can still see how rigid that is. As you push the pace, this keeps up with you. Now, this is going to be more of a somewhat plush ride. It's not as squishy as maybe you would think, but you do not feel the ground at all. and as you push off, it has a nice bounce to it. For me, this was just really well balanced. I'm also about 245 pounds, so my enjoyment is gonna be different than yours. Now, this may be too much cushion for some. If you're not heavy enough, you might not feel that carbon plate enough. The cushion might not be bouncy, again, if you're not compressing it enough. So there's a lot of folks who may not like this. Depending if you're a heel striker or if you're a 4 foot, mid foot striker, this is going to run a little bit different for you. But if we're just talking about max cushion, most comfortable shoe with a plate, number three goes to the Adidas Prime X. All right, number two is a toss up. I'm gonna grab them both here, guys. And I say it's a toss up because it's gonna depend more on your foot, your fit, your level of comfort, and that's gonna be your New Balance RC2 Elite, or RC Elite 2, and your ASICS Meta Speed Sky. Now, I did have the Meta Speed Edge. I did sell that. I may do a comparison video. If they're next to each other, you can't tell the difference. It's the exact same shoe outside of the aggressiveness of the angle of the push off. ASICS did it perfectly well. If you actually have a higher cadence the faster you go, the Edge works perfectly. If you actually do longer strides, more contact, this works perfectly. And having both, this one just worked better for me. The RC Elite, the first gen, was one of my favorite shoes. The fit, the amount of cushioning, which again is not as nearly as much cushion as I think any of our top five, but it just fit my foot. It just rolled really well, similar to like the Hyperion Elite, how it just works with your foot. I have two pairs of those. RC Elite 2, New Balance, kicked it up a notch. The cushion on this is the softest, bounciest, the fuel cell. This blew the Alpha Fly out of the water. Like, what you're spending on this is absolutely elite, from the upper that is just beautifully well made. It's almost like this knit, the cushion, and then even to the amount of rubber you get on the outsole, that you would think a shoe that would be a racing shoe that's this light shouldn't have as much rubber, and maybe it shouldn't, but everything about this shoe is amazing outside of two things. And again, it's going to depend on you, the runner. For me, the RC Elite 2 is the second best, and it's going to boil down to two things. The Meta Speed Sky fit me just better. This is a 12, this is a 12 and a half. These run just super narrow, couldn't even fit in a 12. Maybe I should do a 13 in this. This, even with a wide foot, the 12 in this just fit me so much better. The 12 and a half in this does fit me, but it's just a much more narrow last. And I don't know if you guys can see it, because it doesn't look like much from the bottom. You really can't quite tell. And that's because the New Balance flares out quite a bit more. And hopefully you guys can see that from where your foot sits to where it's fading out. This is a little bit more even. You can see there's not as much flaring. So where your foot sits is pretty much where the bottom of the shoe is. Now, the second aspect is to how it feels. I feel like this has a little bit more bounce, or maybe the exact same amount of bounce, but it's not quite as soft. So when I'm landing, I don't feel like I'm squishing down as far, but I'm getting that pop. This is just utterly squishy, bouncy, mushy, whatever you want to call it, but it does all of that while also slingshotting you past the screen. So let me just pushing you forward. It is incredible. The carbon plate, how it works with the fuel cell cushioning. If you want the softest cushioning, and a lot of the folks who ran an Alpha Fly did switch to this, this is incredible. So maybe this should be number one. We're talking about just pure cushion. And the reason I like this one is I'm still getting that softness, but I'm still getting the same bounce, maybe more bounce, just because I'm not squishing as much, and it just works with my foot so much more. I think a lot of racers, a lot of runners will agree either one of these, depending on your style of running, on what your preferences are incredible and just change the market. Now, next year we have upgrades coming from Saucony that isn't even on here with their Speed and their Pro, which the year before this, so 2 years ago, with their first generation was on here. You have Brooks coming out with new versions here. You have Skechers coming out with more stuff. And then even New Balance has an all-new racing line with their SC. You guys can check out the shoes I'm looking for most to in 2022. I haven't seen anything from ASICS, but at the same time, really all I want is more colors. This is all it comes in. And I just wish it came in other colorways. Even though this is super cool, I don't want to double up on the exact same shoe. Give me something a little bit more. The RC Elite actually has some amazing colorways. I'm happy with this purple one. I think it looks really cool. They did a great job in a lot of the looks of this one. But because it didn't quite fit me, I'm waiting for next year's version, their training version, the fuel cell cushioning. Absolutely love it. Either one of these two are your top two. For me, at least, it's going to be number two and number one. For everyone else, for just max cushion with a plate, I think it's probably going to be number two and then number one. Ladies and gentlemen, hopefully you guys enjoyed that video. Hopefully it broke down what shoes you should be looking for. There's a lot of different companies represented here. A lot of awesome cushioning by so many different companies, and they're all doing it their own way. I love the engineering that goes into all of these, and there are some fantastic running shoes coming out for the next year. I think there was 10 different pairs I was excited to try, which is a lot of shoes that I really don't need. I need to run even more, really put my training and test what's coming out and put these comparisons to the table. If you guys have any questions or one of these broken down or compared to each other, let me know. What I actually want to come out with is going to be which company has the best set. The two or three shoes you should buy just from one company. So if you're looking at Skechers, it's maybe the Road Max combined with maybe the Razor XS, and then the Race Day shoe, which is like their Speed Freak. So you have one company where you're gonna have two or three shoes. Which company does it best, and how does it break it down for each runner? If you guys are interested in that, please consider subscribing down below and let me know what you think, what you're running in. And as always, this is Levi with Sneaker Gears, and I will come at you later.